Hey guys, it's Lolo. Welcome back to my channel. Today I have a very special guest on my channel.
Hi.
It is my mommy, Athena.
Thanks for having me, Lolo.
And today she's going to show us how she covers up her grays. And then she's also going to take us through her curly hair routine because I learned everything I know about my hair and how to take care of my hair from her. So
it's true.
I figure she should show us the OG way.
Alright, unfortunately as you get older you will have gray hair too, if you're so lucky. And I started getting gray hair at 18, so I'm a pro at this point. So okay, I'll get started.
Yeah, so it's not really that much. How often do you?
Oh, it's not that much because every 2 to 3 weeks I have to do it. And actually you might see a little bit of mascara that's covering up some because I can't color it every time I see a new gray, so I have a little mascara that I'll put in there. Important though, before you do anything to your hair, that you protect your skin, especially if you're a little more fair and you stain easily like I do. And I really like this Brilliance by Aveda to do it. Doesn't break my skin out, it smells good, and it's really easy to apply because it's just a nice little texture. So you just put a little bit and just get around your edges because you don't want to have a permanent hairline. And if you don't apply this, you will. Sometimes I leave the shop when I do it at Aveda and I actually have a permanent hairline for like a couple days. But in between going to get it done, I do it myself because it's really expensive if you go to the shop every time. I mean, literally it's like 65, 70 bucks and they always want to tack on the curly hair extra price and long hair extra price. So it can be $100. But for $9, you can use this. And this is the one I like the best. It's for people like me that are kind of lazy because it's called the touch-up kit. And everything you need is in there. And you just mix up a tiny bit and it goes really far even with all this hair. And so that allows me for $9 to keep my hair pretty fleeked and nice. And I'm going on vacation soon and I don't want to be in the sun and having all these gray hairs sticking out like a sore thumb. Usually start at the area that you want to get the most protection. And so of course that's around the front. And if you see when I hair it in a bun, it's really gray. So I start right around the hairline and be generous around the front because that's really what matters. I usually have 2 boxes of this on hand just in case I run out. Sometimes my husband comes in and he's like, could you hit me up real quick? Cause he likes how his hair looks when it's not brown after he's been to the barber shop. Even though it says semi-permanent, it washes out. And you gotta be careful because we all use things to lighten our complexion, lighten dark spots, help with pimples, all that stuff bleaches your hair out as well. And I really believe that's why I get more gray right around the front and my sideburns, because I do do a 3 or 4 step process every night for moisturizing. And you know, I am 54 by the way, so I have to stay on top of things. Oh no, can't mess up these. I forgot my gloves. God forbid I go to the nail salon and my nail tech will yell at me because I got these nice long fingernails right now. Little dots of dye fly everywhere and that is why I'm in a black robe, because 2 reasons. It's gonna collect the extra that I spill, and also I'm gonna have to get this off my head because again, I told you I'm lazy, so I'm gonna get in the shower to rinse this out. I don't have anyone who's gonna wash my hair. I'm not gonna do it in the sink. And so, you know, put on something that you can easily remove. Little black dots get on here, won't matter. And also be careful of your floor. You're not supposed to get it on your scalp, so whoever's out there who's a professional is gonna say, oh, you're touching your scalp. Yeah, I know. So I'm just gonna, see on my forehead. I'll have to get that off in a minute before we let it cook in there. So I'm gonna take this, and then I just kind of throw a scrunchie, and then I'll have her help me with the back. So I won't put all that in yet, and I'll do this. All right, Lauren, can you grab the back for me real quick? Thank you. So we try to be careful. I have it on my arm. I think I have it on my bracelet. So just want to cover up as best you can. And then I use a makeup remover wipe, any kind that you have, and your favorite kind. Just wipe around the edges and any little dots that you might have put on, you want to wipe off. You want to get that off. But thank goodness we put the Brilliance from Aveda on earlier, because that will help you to get it off. See how it's just wiping off really easily? That's really good. And then I will clean my arm and, you know, do all that stuff. And if it gets on your skin, you might want to do a light exfoliation just to make sure you have it all the way off. So we're not done yet. Now, also, this says it's 10 minutes, but it stops cooking, you know, at 10 minutes. So you don't have to worry that you're gonna over process your hair. It's not like a perm or a lightening product. It's just black. Black actually makes your hair seal and look shiny. So I'm gonna leave it on longer, and grays take a little longer. So always leave it on a little extra. But now we get to do our eyebrows. What I like to do is just kind of make sure they're brushed out. Make sure you don't have any, you know, makeup on, concealer on, or whatever, just to really expose your skin. And then I just take you could use a Q-tip if you don't have a makeup eyebrow brush, but I have one because I have two daughters, and they make sure that I do. And you just rub it in, just kind of, and you can actually, what I do is I fill in a little bit more, like if you want more eyebrows than you normally have, just go ahead and overline it a little bit, like you would do your lips. And that's fine. And it, you know, really does give you that extra little pizzazz. Oh, and if you're like me, unfortunately, I've had the pleasure or displeasure of finding gray eyebrows. Oh my God. Your hair grays everywhere, just not on your head. So if you're trying to dye your hair something other than natural color, you might want to hit down there as well, so there's no surprises later. Want to dye some eyebrows today?
Yeah.
All right, let's do you. Okay. Can you come in here? Mm-hmm. And you're saving yourselves about 40, 50 bucks because they charge to tint eyebrows at the salon too, and they literally just do this. I've had it done and I was really disappointed.
Good job, Mom. I like to add a little bit more in the front because I fill in my eyebrows towards the center a little bit, so I'm gonna just stain my skin, and then the same thing with the tail end.
I'm gonna let this sit here probably like 15 minutes just to get those grays really cooked. Then I'm gonna pop in the shower and wash it all out, and I'll be back to show you what I do to get my curl pattern back. Thanks. All right, I'm back. So, took a shower, noticed my eyelashes fell off, so that's okay. I used shampoo through the ends, but I didn't use a lot of shampoo up here because I just wanted to really soak in and bake into my grays. The shampoo I use, of course, you already know I am an Aveda fanatic, and this is the Color Conserve, and it just helps. It doesn't have any sulfate, so it doesn't pull the color right out of your hair. And then I needed some extra conditioning, so I used a little bit of the JUNO Co. Sometimes I use the Color Conserve conditioning, but this is actually a really good conditioner. And you can even get this one at TJ Maxx for $8. So I'm just gonna add a little bit more moisture back in. And it's like a little conditioning, and it has a nice scent too. So if you've been out the night before and you absorb some smoke, get some of this. Just spray a little bit of this on, and it'll just kind of help refresh it. Even some conditioner for curly hair, especially if you live in the desert where we do. So I like the Be Curly Aveda line. And you know, they'll say use like this much, when really you gotta use this much. Make sure you smooth these edges. Edges are always smoothed in, even though people like to say I don't have any. I do. Just gotta pay a lot of attention to them. And you're just gotta be, can't have a tender head. Got to pull it in, stretch those curls out, and then I always spread it out in the back and just straighten out the kitchen as well, or the nape of your neck if you want to be nicer. Get the extra hair off your hand, don't put it in the sink because your mama's going to kill you. Next step is Jessie's. Miss Jessie's has great products. The Quick Curls and the Pillow Soft are my absolute favorite. The secret to any curl routine, I was at a party the other night, and there were Caucasian women and some black women with curly hair, and they all kept saying to me, what do you put in your hair? Why are your curls so nice? I'm trying to get my curls so nice. And I said, the key is you got to put a lot and you have to make a salad. And by that I mean there's several ingredients that go along with. So you work the product in again. As you notice, I'm squeezing it together and putting a lot of pressure and tension because you really want to stretch your curls and then let them get spring back. The Confixer, it's a lightweight gel by Aveda. And it's nice because it doesn't flake. It just kind of seals it in, keeps some of the moisture out. Scrunching basically just means help your curls remember that they're supposed to be bouncing back. And finally, I don't care what you say, what kind of hair you have, you always need hairspray. The best hairspray on the market. The Moroccan oil hairspray has a fine mist. Spray it all over in the back. And if you notice areas that might have separated too much and you want a couple of big curls, just grab them, smooth them, and wrap them around your finger. Pull it off, and then it'll dry like that. So sometimes I do that when I want a little more definition. So thanks for tuning in. Thanks, Lolo, for having me. Any nice comments are appreciated. Keep the negative ones to yourself, because that's what your mama taught you. And hopefully I'll be invited back. Thanks.
Well, she walked off set, y'all.
She said, bye.
She said,
well, here it is when it's dry. Outside, it's been like about a couple hours, it dried out. A little bit of frizz right here, so this is where I told you to go back in and wrap it separately, and you can just kind of define it around your face. But this is what you'll get.